guys, Coach Becca here. I'd like to welcome you to my Core and More workout. You don't need any equipment for today, and I'll demonstrate the entire session. We're going to begin with a dynamic forward bend, as I'm showing here, where you just take a deep breath in, reach towards the toes, take a deep breath out, and reach towards the ceiling. We're going to wake up the entire body today, and guys, I really want to stress that each movement today is going to be intentional and help improve your stability, mobility, and core. We're going to train from the inside out, from the bottom to the top today. So whether you're an athlete or a mom and pop just trying to get in some COVID shape here, I'm here to help you. All right, up next, we're going to do an inchworm. So that just means reach towards the toes, bending the knees as you need to. Walk out into a plank and then walk back up, stretching out the legs and standing tall. If you don't have as good a flexibility here where you feel like you can't do this movement well, it is okay to bend the knees as you need to. Walk out into a plank, that's just gonna wake up your core and give your legs a nice stretch. This is one of my favorite warm-up movements because it lifts the heart rate a little bit, turns things on while giving you a good stretch. So turn the core on, turn the glutes on as you stand up, and just get that breathing under control. Deep breaths in through the nose and out through your mouth. All right, from here, let's sit back onto the knees. Hips go back towards the feet. This is just a great child's pose stretch here to give the lats a little bit of a mobility stretch and a feel-good movement. That's great at the beginning or end of a workout. Practice that nose inhalation, mouth exhalation. All right, come on forward now, dropping the hips towards the floor, rolling the shoulders back, stretching out those hip flexors, stretching out that core, untucking the shoulders away from the ears. A few deep breaths here as well. Upward dog. Curl the toes underneath and drive the hips now towards the ceiling, adjusting your feet and your hands so that you're in a comfortable but stretching position. You want to feel this in the back of your legs and stretching the lower back. We're going to move into a single leg down dog from here, so just raise one leg, exhale, and drive the knee towards your hands. We're going to do five of these. So here's number two and number three. Here's a great time to inhale, and here's a great time to exhale. Big stretch, big squeeze through the core. Good. You can come on back to down dog now, and we're just going to pedal out the feet to stretch the calves. Just again, waking things up here. Find an appropriate position for your body. Your body is going to move differently than mine, whether you have more mobility or less, more strength or less. This workout can be done at all levels, so find the appropriate position and intensity for you. A great calf stretch and lat stretch. All right, we're going to do the opposite side now. So raise one leg back as you inhale. Exhale, drive the knee towards the hands. Just, again, waking up your core as you drive that knee, kind of crunching through your abdominals. Waking up your whole body here. And walk it back into down dog. Take a few deep breaths here after doing five of those. Excellent. Drop down to the knees. Sit back on the heels and take a deep breath here. If you need to grab water, reset, get into a new area. For me, I just gotta tie the hair back a little bit so we can get into our next movement. And it's gonna be cat and cow breathing. So inhale, you're gonna arch your back. Exhale, scoop your lower back. This one's all about getting movement through your spine. So you wanna just get your spine moving as much as possible. Avoid using your arms for this. Sometimes people try to move into a push-up position. That's fine, but really the focus needs to be on your spine. Really focus on arching and then scooping, if you will, or arching up and then arching down. You might also think of your pelvis. So here I'm gonna tuck my pelvis kind of down as I squeeze my glutes, and here I'm gonna tilt my pelvis. So tucking and tilting the pelvis might help paint a better picture for you. Either way, a great way to get your breathing down. Inhale as you arch, exhale as you scoop. Get the tailbone going. Just a great one for your spine. Great at the beginning, great at the end of a workout. All right, we're gonna bring in a little bit of a lunge twist now. So we're gonna alternate legs on this. You'll step forward into a lunge and rotate forward towards your front leg. 90 degree twist. Here's a here's what it looks like from the front, and then you can jump in here. Forward lunge to twist. Forward lunge to twist. Take your time getting your balance, figuring out your area. This is just working the legs and the core. I like combining planes of movement, so as you can see here, I'm moving forward and backwards in the lunge, but I'm rotating with that twist. So that's just, you know, a way to make a movement a little more functional is to cross planes of movement like that. And in doing so, I work not only my legs, but I work my core as well. It's also good, kind of a good balance exercise because I'm alternating which foot is in front and pushing off, etc. So kind of a 2-for-1 there, and we did 12 repetitions. All right, windmills. Bring one arm overhead and pack that shoulder into the joints. You're gonna reach the opposite hand towards the floor, specifically right underneath the fist that you made. So it's important to keep that shoulder packed in and strong. I like to keep my eyes on the prize or my eyes on my top fist. And in doing so, that's gonna help me rotate through my trunk as I reach towards the ground. Windmills are great for mobility in your hips and spine, and stability in your shoulder joint on the top here. So again, make a fist, pull that shoulder into the joint, pack that shoulder in, that's where we're working shoulder stability, and then reach towards the floor. Rotating through your spine, hinging at your hips, lining those hands up. Just a great kind of total, but it goes with our theme today. We might be stretching the lower half while working the upper half or core. It's never just an isolated movement today. It's the entire body or the entire kinetic chain working together. All right, very good, guys. Next, we're gonna do an ankle mobility drill, the iso split lunge. So step one foot in front of the other and then go up onto your toes. Once your heels are off the floor, lower down into a deep lunge. Take 5 deep breaths, in through your nose, out through your mouth. It's gonna be about a 20-second hold, but I'm doing this more timed by breaths. And as you can see, I have my fingertips kind of inserted into my diaphragm so I can feel that rigid core helping me stay stable. Let's switch sides, one foot in front of the other. Lift the heels off the floor, lower down, 5 deep diaphragm breaths. Again, using that trunk to keep you stable and strong. Working those ankles. Ankle mobility, turning on the quads and glutes, being strong from the inside out. Excellent job. Great one for stability, great one for ankles. Speaking of ankles and stability, we're moving right into tree pose next. So place the instep of one leg on the thigh of the other, hands go on your hips. And I'm gonna take about 5 to 8 deep breaths here, about 20 to 30 seconds. This single leg position works ankle stability, knee stability, and hip stability. Why it's incorporated here. While I'm doing this, I'm focused on that diaphragm breathing. I keep bringing that up today. It's important. Inhale deeply through your nose, out through your mouth. Excellent job. Let's switch sides here. Wiggling those toes on the floor. Getting your balance, digging in, squeezing the abs together for balance, finding your breath. And diaphragm breathing is great also, I mean, for those of you that might struggle with anxiety or depression or just kind of the feeling of the walls closing in, you know, in times like quarantine. So use that inhale, 4 count, hold for 4 count, exhale for 4 count. That diaphragm breath can really help in times of stress as well as when you're training or exercising. All right, going to get back into that split lunge position. We're going to do an alternating overhead reach. I'm going to aim for about 12 overhead reaches. So 1 foot in front of the other. I'm holding that stable split lunge and then just kind of stretching the obliques, working some mobility overhead, working my core laterally now. All right, so similar to that lunge twist, similar to that ankle mobility hold, but just changing the focus, getting some lateral reach in as I hold my feet in one split lunge position. All right, change feet, split lunge position, alternating lateral overhead reaches, firing up those obliques, trying to maintain stability in the lower half while the upper half reaches into that lateral plane of movement. It's tricky. The bottom half is definitely working on stability. Quads are working to hold you up there. Glutes are working. Arms are working. Legs are going to feel the burn a little bit here, but you're doing great. Relax and smile a little bit. Even if you falter, that's totally fine. Well done. You made it through the first 10 minutes, guys. Next is a fun one, just a basic squat to a push. So feet are shoulder width apart. You're going to exhale as you push. Inhale as you squeeze your shoulder blades back, pulling the hands back to the armpits. Push, pull on the arms, up, down on the legs. So another multi-planar movement here. Push, pull, push, and pull. This is a great movement that's just kind of compound, you know, more than one thing going on at a time. More than one plane of movement working at a time. Your arms are pushing and pulling. Your legs are going up and down. Per usual today, we're doing about 12 to 15 reps of everything. So great job there. On your bum now, we're going to do a single leg bridge. So laying flat on your back. This one's great for the hamstrings, glutes, and core. You're going to push your hips off the ground. And now I like to add ankle mobility into these also because I like to distract my mind from what my bottom half is doing. So keeping your bottom foot flat on the floor and hips elevated, just point and flex about 10 to 15 times, getting a little ankle mobility work in, a little ankle strength in there while we work the glute bridge position. Switch sides here, drive the hips off the floor. Again, crushing the walnut in your glute, squeezing your abs together, and then working that ankle point and flex. The glute bridge is one of my favorite movements, and there's so many ways to do it. This is just one of my favorites. Excellent work. We're gonna take this right into just a regular old glute bridge now, so drop the hips down to the floor. Both feet on the ground, pressing your hips up and down as you inhale and exhale. Think about squeezing your glutes, crushing the walnut, sometimes like to say that way. Really crushing the core, crushing the glutes. Press the hips up and down. Up, down. Well done. As usual, I'm doing all the reps with you today. A few more here. Training those glutes, toning the butt, toning the core. Straighten the legs out in front of you. I'm gonna demonstrate a few reps here so you guys can take a look. We're gonna do straight leg sit-ups. If you can't do full sit-ups, here's your option. Roll the shoulders off the floor with straight legs. Full option is here, and you guys can jump in with me now. Exhale as you roll the shoulders forward. Trying to stretch into a little bit of a forward bend there, just kind of combining some core strength with a little bit of hamstring and lower back mobility. Looking strong here, you guys. Well done. And we're coming up on our forward bend here. So hold up at the top of this sit-up and hold a forward bend stretch for the hamstrings and lower back. About a 15-second hold here. So just take some deep nose inhalations, mouth exhalations. Great work, and we're halfway through our workout now, guys. Well done. All right, following that seated forward bend, we're gonna do Hollywood stretch. So cross one leg over the other and rotate towards that leg. So I've crossed my right leg over my left and I'm rotating towards my right leg. Taking some deep breaths here, stretching out kind of the IT band area as well as the spine, a little bit in the middle of your back, your T-spine. So this hits the hips and the spine, so I enjoy the Hollywood stretch. Take some deep breaths. Today is all about mobility, stability, flexibility, and core from the inside out, core stability. Really, it's a functional movement session, you guys. Important for everyone to do workouts like this one today. All right, it's time for plank to pull. So you're gonna get in a forearm plank and push from your toes. You're essentially pulling yourself from your shoulders over your elbows to your shoulders over your hands. So instead of going up and down with your hips, try to go forward and back from your shoulders. It's almost like you're trying to do an ab dolly or an ab wheel, but without the equipment. You're just pushing from your ankles, pulling your shoulders forward. Keeping those hips flat. Well done. And now we're going to stretch out the T-spine. So on all fours, place one hand on the towards the opposite knee, and then open up towards the ceiling. I'm only going to do about 8 of these. So big rotations here. This is great for the spine, the middle of your back here. Great if you're somebody that sits a lot or rides a bike or just kind of has poor posture. It could really be all of us falling into one of those three categories. Very good. Switch sides. Reaching your hand to the opposite knee and then rotating up. Great one for the spine here. As we come to the 10-minute to-go mark. Lots of good stuff still ahead. Excellent work. Okay, so we're going to go back to that plank position. Kneeling or full, you can do this kneeling. So down the straight first, you're going to push up, up, and then come down, down before switching sides. All right, so I'm going to do an alternating elevator here. Up, up, down, down, up, up, down, down, right, left, left, right, left, right, right, left. Or you could do, say, 6 to 8 on one side, 6 to 8 on the other side. That's totally fine. I just like to switch back and forth so my brain's always thinking about something versus the exercise that I'm doing. A little coordination always helps distract me. Well done. We did about 30 seconds of those, or if you want to do just 5, 6 per side. And up next is my favorite shoulder mobility, the shoulder car. So you're in the half kneeling position. My right knee is in front, my left knee is down. I'm making a fist with my right hand, and now I'm just rotating that fist in all directions of the shoulder joint. So I'm going to come forward, rotate it back, and then down. I'm almost pretending there's a wall next to me, and I'm trying to get my arm to go full circle around that wall. And this is actually a great one to do against a wall if you have one. Up, around, and back. You want to keep that fist as close to you as possible. Let's switch sides. About 5 or 6 per side, 10 to 12 total. Left arm, rotate it back. Just notice how close I'm keeping that hand to my body. A controlled articular rotation, or a car, a shoulder car. So it's about improving your mobility, improving your control of that shoulder joint to avoid injuries, and improve your performance, whether you're an athlete that requires that, or just somebody that wants to have the best movement through their shoulders without getting injured. Most people get injuries in their shoulders and hips because they're ball and socket joints, which means you've got a lot of range of motion and actions that can go through them. All right, plank on your hands. We're going to do an alternating leg lift. Full plank for this one is needed. But don't worry, we're not going to do too many reps. Squeeze the glutes to get the action going here. This one's training your glutes and your hamstrings, lengthening your hip flexors while you're in that full plank position. Try to keep your hips flat. Don't worry about how high you're reaching your leg. Just try to fire up those glutes while you work your core. Great job. One of my favorite core exercises. Little bits of core with a lot of stretching and mobility. Okay, here's another fun one. Reach down towards the ground, bending your knees as needed. Take a lunge back, drop to the knees, lower down into a push-up, hand release style, strong core, up to the toes, plank position, walk the toes in. We've just made a burpee into a total body strength and mobility exercise. Again, reach down forward, bend, lunge it back, drop to the knees, chest to the floor, hands go out, squeezing the shoulders back, tight core pushing up, toes curled underneath, walk the toes in. Stand it all the way up. Reaching down towards the floor, bending the knees as needed, lunging back, drop to the knees. Chest comes all the way to the ground, release the hands to the side, strong core as you push up, toes underneath, walk the toes in, stretching out those legs, standing all the way up. Very nice, you guys. I believe we're doing about 5 total here. Another great total body exercise. It's, again, not about crushing your intensity today. It's just about really treating your body well, cluing into your body. I am showing the full version now. If you don't want to do a kneeling hand release push-up, you can do a full push-up like I'm demonstrating now, or stick with the kneeling version. Looking really dynamic and functional out there, you guys. Let's do one more here. Squeeze those hands, push up strong, walk those toes in. fantastic job. All right, we're in our final segments now, so we're going to do a side lunge and reach over our head. Step together, other side, side lunge, reach overhead. Really similar to what we did in that static lunge with the overhead reach, but now we're adding a side lunge into it. So again, just lots of variety on basic movements like squats, lunges, planks, and push-ups, burpees even, but we're just making it a little bit more creative, if you will. Adding in different planes of movement, different tempos, holding positions, different planes of movement, different compound movements, overhead reach. So we're getting the lats involved, a little bit of a dynamic stretch there, getting the obliques in. The lateral lunge is obviously great for your legs and your glutes and your hips, giving you some good stretches on the adductors there, the inside of the legs. Just another feel-good movement today that gives you more than, you know, two things for one, if you will. All right, this one's a tough one, guys. You're going to do a single leg hold, so get to this position first, and maybe just focus on getting to this position and holding it. After you've got your core cinched together, you're going to do some overhead reaches while holding a single leg position. It's really tough. So if you need to, focus on just getting to the single leg reach hold. Once you get more stability in your ankle and your core, you'll be able to add the overhead reach in. So again, ankle, knee, and hip stability here, strong core, that's how I'm able to push my arms overhead without losing my balance. So core stability and then ankle, knee, and hip stability. If you're somebody that's like, wow, my balance really sucks, you've got to work on your ankle joint. You got to train from the bottom up and the inside out. And you don't have to be perfect, right? But work on getting that stability first in your core and in your ankles. Well done on that tough movement. Okay, now we're going to do alternating scarecrows. Bending your elbows at 90 degrees. Alternate pulling your palms down or your knuckles back. That's a side view for you there. Easy for people to start doing this with their wrists. And you want to make the shoulders do all the work here. I'm almost kind of aiming my hands back to the wall behind me. It's just a good mental image to have, but you might also enjoy doing this on a wall for an added push, an added feel of the physical target there. You guys are doing great. We've got just 3 minutes to go. All right, standing up nice and tall, shoulders over your ankle, lateral leg raise for the glutes, IT band, even for your core a little bit, cinching your core together. A little lateral movement here as we balance on one leg. Little balance, a little bit of lateral mobility or side to side mobility. Switching sides here. This one's fun to do just laying on the ground, but I enjoy the standing version to add a little bit of balance factor in, make my core do a little work to support me up and down here. Fantastic. And now we're just going to do some simple calf raises. Probably the only isolated movement we're doing today. These final movements here. Just up and down on the toes, a little ankle extension. If you want to get some breathing in here, now's a good time to do it. Stretch out those calves. Up next, we're going to do a quad stretch, and I'm going to show you two ways to do that quad stretch. So this is probably the more advanced option. If you have the balance to just grab an ankle or the mobility to just grab your ankle and stretch, lifting the opposite arm straight over my head. Or if you don't have that ability, or just prefer this version better, get to a wall, place one foot on the wall until you can feel a stretch, and then sit into that stretch as deeply as you can, and you should feel that stretching out your legs. You'll have to manipulate your foot based on your mobility, so you might need to go lower or higher, but here's another way to stretch out your quads. You might still just be holding that first option, and if so, you can switch sides here. And again, the goal is just to feel the front part of your leg from your hip down to your knee, your quads. So as long as you're feeling a type of stretch here, that's fine. The other option is to obviously still be holding that single leg ankle hold. You guys did a great job today. Thanks for joining me on this functional session. Again, it's not always about how hard a workout is or how sore it makes you. It's about how productive it is, how much long-term benefits it'll reap you. All right, we're just going to go back and forth between a child's pose stretch for the lats and lower back into an upward dog stretch for your hips and core. So stretching back, stretching forward, inhale, exhale, as we come to the end of our workout here today. Great job. Just kind of getting that breathing under control. Take that with you for the rest of your day and enjoy. Thanks so much for joining. Don't forget to subscribe to stay up to date on any new workouts that I post weekly. And be sure to visit www.kawaokacoaching.com for recipes, wellness blogs, and more.